My name is Emily Fireoven. The piece, or pieces of art, I'm going to present today is Shuttlecocks, perhaps one of the most famous series of works at the Nelson Atkins Museum of Art in my hometown, Kansas City, Missouri. They are a provocative preview for the treasures that lie inside the museum itself. Klaas Oldenburg and Kuji Van Bruggen are the artists that came up with and developed these iconic structures in 1994. These realistic, yet enlarged, badminton shuttlecocks still reside at the lawn at the museum today.
Klaas Oldenburg and Kuji Van Bruggen, born in 1929 and 1942 respectively, were actually husband and wife, up until Kuji's death in 2009. Oldenburg, originally from Stockholm, Sweden, is most famously known for creating some of the first soft sculptures made of fabric and other smooth materials. Many of these included food items such as burgers and ice cream. The two were married in 1977 and went on to create over 40 sculptures together across the globe. By making ordinary objects the focus of their art rather than depicting more traditional, heroic, and commemorative subjects, they challenged conventions and reinvigorated the history of sculpture. Clothespin, 1976, located in Philadelphia, is a great example of an everyday, ordinary object created on a monumental scale and displays the couple's very unique style. Inspiration for shuttlecocks came from a painting inside the museum by Frederick Remington that featured Native Americans wearing feathered headdresses, coupled with a satellite image of the museum grounds that resembled a grassy ball court. In 1994, the husband and wife team installed the sculptures in Kansas City. Scattered across the lawns of the Nelson Atkins lie four noteworthy shuttlecocks that are virtually impossible to miss. At 18 feet high apiece, they look as if they rest after a long, tiresome game of badminton. Three of the game pieces reside on one side of the museum, with the other on the opposite lawn. Although a seemingly random arrangement, it was deliberately chosen to incorporate the building into the overall design as the net for this larger-than-life set of game pieces. The installation initially got negative reviews and caused quite a bit of controversy that usually surround modern pieces of art. However, they quickly gained recognition and admiration and are now viewed as a beloved icon of my city. The lawns are a site for weddings, professional pictures, and other social gatherings, with the sculptures as a commemorative background. My own prom pictures were taken there, and the scale and detail of one of the sculptures can undoubtedly be seen. The shuttlecocks were made to look realistic, representing what they actually look like. Many formal elements are put into effect when attempting to make something look real. One of the most important aspects of the sculptures are their texture. Our textbook defines texture as the surface characteristics of an object. It goes on to state that texture is associated with the tactile sense and indirectly with vision. As soon as we see something, we either recognize its texture from experience or we make an assumption based on how it looks. By looking at the feathers of the sculptures, we can almost infer what it would feel like to touch them. Though the actual texture of the sculpture is hard, the simulated, or implied, texture gives off the look of softness and flexibility. So for someone who has never felt an actual shuttlecock before, they can get an idea of what it would be like. Texture is a main and very important aspect with these pieces. If the feathers would have just been smooth and plain, they would not actually look like feathers. The sculptures would be dramatically different, and the realistic effect would be lost. Aside from the texture, another obvious element are their size. At 18 feet high apiece, the scale of these sculptures is something that can't be overlooked. From a bird's eye view and due to the grassy surroundings, the shuttlecocks look average, somewhat simple, and, but not actually, small. This was intended by the artists. It's all about perspective. The shuttlecocks don't have a lot of mystery to them. What you see is what you get. They are larger-than-life game pieces, everyday, ordinary objects. When attempting to approach these pieces of art using a methodology, I had some trouble. None of the methods seemed to fit. I chose iconology, since there are technically four sculptures, a program, and since the arrangement of the pieces was a very important factor when drawing up the blueprints. According to the textbook, the sculptures are considered pop art, and Klaas Oldenburg is among one of the leading pop artists. His sculptures illustrates his enlargement of objects that are small in everyday experience. Clothespin, a giant clothespin in Philadelphia, reflects Oldenburg's talent for conveying paradox and metaphor. Some other sculptures include a huge teddy bear in New York and lipstick in London. Although it is a broad subject, pop art is derived from everyday objects and the media. Oldenburg successfully portrays this in all of his sculptures. Another famous pop artist, Andy Warhol, stated that everything is beautiful. Pop is everything. Pop artists make ordinary things extraordinary. I chose these sculptures out of love for the Nelson Atkins in my hometown. Ever since I was little, the museum has been my favorite place to visit in Kansas City. As mentioned earlier, these sculptures are iconic and create a very distinct style about the museum. The modern pieces seem somewhat out of place next to the classical building, but in my opinion, it works. They are grand and different. They are strange, yet simple. The concept envisioned by Klaus Oldenburg and Kuji Van Bruggen was brilliant, and whenever I pass the magnificent figures, my love for art magnifies.